Missing in action.
Missing in action.
Yeah, how are you doing?
Okay.
What are you doing way over there?
I don't know.
Getting ready to give us some great music tonight?
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, we got a lot coming up with some events, and the Commish will be bringing that out later on. And how was your weekend?
Busy, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. Busy YouTubing?
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll
see if the Commish is coming back in action here.
Drum roll.
Yeah, drum roll.
Keep on talking.
Yes.
What's up? You guys on air?
Yeah, we are on air.
Late, fashionably late. Look at his bling right here, everybody.
Yeah.
He thinks he's too short, whatever.
Yeah, I don't hear myself. I'm not hearing you guys.
No.
Because you're not.
Are you plugged in? Some technical difficulties
probably not,
here.
CX2 didn't plug me in.
There you go.
All right. So I'm getting plugged in right here, man. My headset. Welcome to the Commish Hour. This is the Commish along with DJ CX2, CC Rosso in the house. And
yeah.
Today I'm being put on check, man, because Mama Liz is also in the house. So welcome, Mama Liz. How you doing?
Good. Glad to be here tonight.
Yeah, and this past Sunday, we actually rolled out to pay our respects to the Latin Gents Car Club and the Orange County Viejitos out there in the city of Westminster. They were doing a car show fundraiser for Angel Ramirez, a family member who had passed away from this awful disease of cancer. And we went out there and we paid our respects. What did you think about the car show?
Oh, it was great. It was great to see the great turnout, the full support for the the Ramirez family going through this. It's never easy, and it just was really great to see the full support there, you know, for them.
Yeah, and then talking about tragedies, and then then on Monday we had a tragedy right here in our own backyard.
Yeah.
The city of San Bernardino, you know, we have that school shooting out here.
North Park Elementary.
Yeah, North Park Elementary School. And, you know, I take it to heart because, you know, unfortunately the two young students that were, well, one of them was killed and the other one is in stable condition, I understand.
Yeah, he's recuperating and his family sends her love and thanks.
And I take it to heart because you and I are both school district employees.
Yeah.
And, you know, they were special ed students.
Yeah.
Special education students. And, you know, I don't work with them, but I work pretty close to them out of the department where I work at for Colton Joint Unified. And,
myself,
I know
too.
A lot of the ladies took it pretty hard knowing that it was special ed students that were involved in this shooting.
Yeah, it touched my heart, too, being at working at an elementary level. And, you know, I just, in seeing, you know, we do have, you know, our class there, special needs. And but just our prayers and condolences, you know, to the families affected and to the staff, you know.
Yeah, absolutely, Mama Liz, absolutely. You know, our prayers, our thoughts go out to the Ramirez family out there in Orange County, the Latin Gents Car Club, the Viejitos, Orange County, you know, on their loss of Angel Ramirez, and then also right here at home, the loss of the family, Jonathan, and you know, the couple that, you know, unfortunately had issues in their marriage, and, you know, unfortunately, you know, the husband brought them and chased her down at work, and we've got this terrible tragedy. So our hearts, our condolences go out to all the families, and we pray for them that they could have comfort at this time with their loss.
Definitely.
Man, and talking about all this tragedy, you know, sometimes we just got to take a step back.
Yep.
And, you know, we have to put some laughter in our life. What do you think, Carlos, right? Sometimes, man, we just got to keep moving forward, man. And, you know, keep in mind those people that we lost, those loved ones, but at the same time, man, we gotta, you know, enjoy life. And tonight, right here on the Commish Hour, man, we're gonna be giving out two pairs of tickets to this Friday's Random Comedy Jam out there at the Deja Vu Nightclub in the city of Ontario. So a little later tonight in the show, when you hear the the cue to call in. Call in at 1-888-909-1050. 1-888-909-1050 when we give you the cue to call in. And we're going to be giving out two pairs of tickets, and you'll be enjoying comedy out there with Beto Chulo Varaga and his friends. Beto, you know, was one of the producers for Lighter Shade of Brown back in the day. So we have those tickets. We'll be giving those two pairs out a little later. And remember, when we give you that cue, give us a call here at 1-888-909-1050. And thank you for tuning in to KCAA Radio 102.3 FM out there in the city of Riverside and Moreno Valley, 106.5 FM right here in the area of San Bernardino, 1050 AM all the way out there. We hear that they can get us out there in the Catalina Island area, and we're worldwide at kcaaradio.com. And thank you to all those that are tuned in right now. All right, we're going to let DJ CX2 take it away. You ready to jam, DJ CX2? All right, let's give it to our listeners.
I just can't love the way that I feel. tender love. There's no way out, and I can't love the way that I feel. I just can't love the way that I feel. Your love has a force, got me under your spell. So take me, I'm yours. And I can't love the way that I feel. I just can't love the way that I feel.
You're looking for a lover. Everything you need, you can Now you've been trapped by love. Someone breaks your heart and then he says goodbye. So you say that you'll never love another. Tired of playing games and that's the reason why. But now whenever we're together, there's a certain feeling that we both agree. And it's time that you open up to love. Cause you don't ever try to.
All right, Hinted. Welcome back to KCAA Radio right here in the city of San Bernardino, Loma Linda, Riverside, Moreno Valley, and to all the homies out there in the Orange County area, man. To shout out to the Viejitos and to the Imperials and to the Latin Gents Car Club. Thank you guys for tuning in and watching in on the internet. We appreciate your love out there.
Hi, Primo.
Go ahead.
Hi, Primo Witchy and Joni. It was great hanging out with you Sunday.
Yeah, and then we have right here, man, on the Facebook, we have the City Cruisers looking in right here. Some of the Vice President, I'm going to call her the Vice President of the City Cruisers. All right, and we got Gus Jr. watching in. Henry Garcia, the manager out there, Gus Jr., man.
Hi, Henry.
Hey, but we want to give out some tickets. We have two pairs of tickets that we want to give out to this Friday. At the Deja Vu nightclub in Ontario. It's a random comedy jam with Beto Chulo Varga and his friends out there. Great show is going to go down. So if you'd like to win those tickets, be the first couple of callers right now at 1-888-909-1050. 1-888-909-1050. Give us a call, man. We'd love to hear from you. I'd like to talk to you on the air. But also, Mama Liz, we got some events coming up, right?
Yes, we do. Quite a few.
Yeah, so the Commish and DJ CX2 and Mama Liz, man, we got all kinds of stuff going down. But this Saturday, April 15th, join us for the Inland Empire Lowrider Alliance Easter Picnic taking place at Fairmont Park in Riverside. Come on out. Enjoy. They got baskets and egg hunt going on for the kids. Good family event. Come on out, man. Join us out there at Fairmont Park this Saturday, April 15th, the Inland Empire Lowrider Alliance. And then on Friday, April 21st, Gus's Jr. Cruise Night. That goes down from 7 to 10 p.m. You know, Gus's Jr. always gives out trophies. They do an opportunity drawing. And, you know, they have great food there.
Yeah,
so come on out. And
a lot of great cars to come
enjoy
and see
the night
them.
Right there. Cruise Night with us from 7 to 10 p.m. Mm-hmm. And that's on Friday, April 21st. And then on Saturday, April 22nd,
yes,
we are hosting the Colton Cruise Against Cancer. That cruise every year gets bigger and bigger and bigger.
Yes.
And Mama Liz, she's the one that organizes this. She's has her Relay for Life team called the Team Wobbles. And you want to tell us a little bit more about what's going to be doing out there?
Yes, stop on by. Roland time is at 9 a.m. at Elizabeth Davis Park. And the cruise will start at 10 a.m. and we'll be escorted by our chief of police, the Colton PD. And so come on out. All cars are welcome. We're doing a contest of the best decorated pink or purple to signify recognition
cancer
of
awareness.
Cancer awareness. And yes, and if you bring a case of water, it's going to go to the CARE Project, and you get a raffle ticket for one of our opportunity drawings. So any questions, give me a call at 909-319-3340. I'd love to have all you guys come out and show up.
All right. And then also going down on May 6th, that's Friday, May 6th, Cinco de Mayo weekend, the Southern Cal Knights is having their car show at the 2020 Bar and Grill. That's taking place right here in the city of San Bernardino from 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. Come on out and enjoy that event with us out there at the 2020 Bar and Grill.
Yep, that's going to be a great event there.
And don't forget, Saturday, June 24th, the Uniques Inland Empire Bike and Pedal Car Show out there at the Hooters in Riverside. That takes place once again on Saturday, June 24th. And then get ready, because the Inland Empire Super Show Car and Hop Contest will be coming down Sunday, July 16th. This is sponsored by Old School Ways and Cruising Together Car Club. For more information on that Inland Empire Super Show, get a hold of Johnny at 951-662-1963, 951-662-1963, or get a hold of Alex at 951-410-3945, 951-410-3945, man. So, you know, as you can see, the DJ CX2 and myself, the Commish, we're really, really going to be busy. And with that, too, in a couple weeks, Mama Liz and I, we're leaving to Washington, D.C. I'm so excited, you know.
Me too.
you know, I'm going to be receiving the National School Employees Inspirational Award that's going to take place. They're going to give me that award at the National Botanical Garden in Washington, D.C.
That's going to be nice.
And I'm just excited, man.
Me too.
I'm really excited about
going to
Washington.
That's our little getaway, too.
That's it. That's it. And I'm also excited because today, you know, I'm an Inland Empire boy. You know, I was born in the city of Corona. You know, I'm very involved in politics. So, you know, all the council members in the city of Corona know me. If I go to Riverside, council members there know me. If I go to Paris, the area where I grew up, you know, they know me. So today, when I was at work, my cell phone rings, and it's the mayor of the city of Paris. And he knows that I pretty much went to all the schools in the city of Paris. So they asked me to come out because they would like to award or actually present to me a proclamation there in the city of Paris because of this award that I'm receiving in Washington, D.C. And then I got a call from the city, the Colton city mayor. So it's just an awesome opportunity.
Yeah.
I'm very excited. You know, I've done what I do for like 20 years. And, you know, it never really hit me. You know, awards and stuff were great, you know, but to receive something of this prestige is just awesome.
Yeah,
it's an awesome
honor
because, you know, everything I do is from the heart. You know, I don't try to do it because I want to shine in front of everybody because I think that, you know, shining comes because you believe in a higher entity, you know, and I'm not a totally religious person, but I do believe there's a God, and sometimes I feel like, you know what, someone up there is watching me, blessing me, and taking care of me, and that's how I feel. All right, and I think right now, I think we have a caller on the line. All right, you want to go ahead and pass them through? Hey, caller, this is the Commish, along with Mama Liz and DJ CX2. Who do we have on the line?
Hola, primo. It's your cousin Beto, Mato.
Hola,
cousin Beto.
Hey, dude.
What's up, Beto?
You better take your immigration card in Washington, D.C., Bato.
Oh, yeah, you better, huh?
President Trump going to get you, eh?
And watch out,
they don't, hey, are you going to fly over there, eh?
Yeah, I'm flying.
Oh, don't get on United, Vato Loco. they'll throw you off the plane, Vato.
He might need a beat down.
Oh, Vato, they'll drag you out, man. He's got that.
I don't know.
Asian guy, like a rat.
Those people don't weigh nothing, eh? I'm not even going to tell you what airline that I'm going to fly on, eh? Because then something might just happen to
me. Yeah, As long as there's no bomber on there, eh?
Yeah.
You're okay, Vato.
Yeah.
You know? It's crazy, man. It's crazy out there.
Hey,
Dolo, man.
Cousin Beto, man. Crazy. You know what? I went over to Tia's house on Sunday, man, and she was sitting there, you know, all triste and everything, and I said, Tia, what's going on? And she said, have you seen your primo Beto? And I said, I ran into him, you know, like on Saturday night. Why? And she said, well, because he still owes me $5.
Yep.
What's up, dude?
And she's going to charge interest.
Well, Beto, I borrowed $5 so I could buy me some weed, and I haven't paid her back. I forgot about that. You know, that weed.
Yeah.
You know, it kind of cures my memory, Beto. I need to get over there.
Is that what they call a 5 cent bank? I didn't even think they have 5 cents bags.
Beto, that was 6 years ago. She still remembers that, right?
Yes, she has a tablet.
Six, dude. She told me it was like 20.
Oh, Beto, man.
Six. She told me it was
26. Hey, I want to give a shout-out to her anyways, eh?
Yes.
My Aunt Helen and my Uncle Louie.
Mm-hmm.
My cousin, Irene.
Yeah, they love you.
Yeah. Right on.
I went to a birthday party for my little niece, eh? Jenny.
Oh,
she's
yeah.
Big 1'6", eh?
Yep.
I think she's the first Mexican chick that I find that killed about pregnant and got two kids, Vato.
Wow.
You know? So she's doing pretty good, I hear. So
yep.
As long as she don't follow my footsteps, Vato, she'll be all right.
Man, I tell you, Primo Beto, you know what, though? I don't know what direction she's heading, eh? But she must be crooked somewhere because she wants to be a politician.
Oh, I didn't hear that, eh? Yeah, that's messed up. I thought, you know, you guys are going to build that wall over there, and you guys are going to, you know.
Well, she told me.
Cents a gallon tax, eh?
She told
you know,
me
that's
that.
Messed up.
She says she's on our side, eh? She says she's going to knock the wall down.
So did Trump.
Yeah.
So Trump said that.
Something
that,
about you know, hitting in with an Audi.
With an Audi.
Crazy, man.
She says,
hey, what's my prima CC up to, eh?
She's right here in Amaz, dude. She's right here at
Colorado. I'm calling from a cell phone, so I gotta.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you got any dedicated song out there that you like to, or you like any give a shout out to anybody?
You know what?
You can have DJ your niece right here, DJ CX2.
Yeah. I want to dedicate a song to my Ruka Teresa, man.
All right.
How about that Angel Baby song you played last week? That's it.
That's
Rosie died, man.
Yeah. All right. She's going to hook it up
right now. Teresa, play that Angel Baby song, eh?
Okay. You want to play that Angel Baby song? All right, man. Let's see if she can hook it up.
Hey, all right, man. The Hooters are here, so I got to get going.
Okay, hey, hurry up. Throw the cell phone away, dude, in the bushes.
All right.
All right, Simon, so right there, we have my Primo Beto call in out there. I don't know where he's at right now, but apparently he's running away from the PD, trying to get away. But he wanted to dedicate a song right here to his Ruka Teresa out there in the city of Corona, Angel Baby. Take it away, DJ CX2. All right, so that song right there, Angel Baby, going out to Teresa from Primo Beto out there in the city of Corona, California. All right, you know, the Commish Hour wouldn't be here if it wasn't for our sponsors, and we'd like to thank our sponsors, Sapo Plastic, right here in the city of San Bernardino, manufacturing American-made plastic tubing at affordable prices. CR England Transportation, you know, if you're ready for a career change, you need to check out CR England Transportation at www.crengland.com. Then we have Photography by Heart, specializing in retro dress photos. Check out her Facebook page at Photography by Heart, and that's H-A-R-T. Then we have Empire Clinical Research, providing paid clinical trials. If they'd like to see you or talk to you, if you have type 2 diabetes, if you have the flu, if you're suffering with arthritis or knee and hip or shoulder pain, give them a call at 909-981-5321. And then we have Gus's Jr., number 14, right here in the city of San Bernardino. You know, they serve breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Mention KCAA Radio and get 10% off your purchase of any of off your purchase. Mill Street, Mill and East Street, right here in the city of San Bernardino, Gus's Jr. And then we have the number one barbershop in the high desert, Top Hats Barbershop in Victorville. Friendly family service specializing in razor fads, beard trims, straight razor shaves, cuts and dyes. And for you, the ladies, the all-exclusive Marilyn Monroe room. Call Monique for an appointment at 760-995-4047. Once again, 760-995-4047. And give a shout out there to all the Inland Empire Car Club, Inland Empire Lowrider Alliance Car Clubs, man. Thank you guys for all your support and love. This is the Commish along with Mama Liz and DJ CX2 right here in the house. And we still have those pair of tickets that we would like to give out for the Random Comedy Show taking place at the Deja Vu nightclub in the city of Ontario. And Deja Vu is, that's not the strip club. This is the new Deja Vu, a nightclub. So, you know, they want you to come out and enjoy some comedy out there. This is going down on Friday, this Friday, the 14th, starting at 7 p.m. And I have two pairs of tickets I want to give out. So please give us a call right here at 1-888-909-1050. 1-888-909-1050. And enjoy some comedy this Friday night. Give us a call, man. We're waiting for you. All right. Let's go back to DJ CX2 in the house. Hey, caller, this is the Commish. Who do I have on the line?
Alice Lizardo.
Hi, what was your name again? Alice?
Yes.
Hi, Alice. How you doing, man? Thank you for calling the Commish Show. So you're a winner, man. Would you like to enjoy a pair of tickets to the Random Comedy Show this Friday?
Sure would.
All right, right on. So we're going to put you on hold, and I'm going to have our sound guy get some information from you so that we can get those, get you on the, actually, it'll be at will call. So you'll just go in and to the event. We'll get you the address and everything, and you'll just show up there and let them give them your name, and they'll have a pair of tickets for you right there at the will call desk.
Congratulations.
Okay. All right. Congratulations, and thank you for listening in to the Commish Hour. All right. We have another caller.
Right
caller,
here.
Caller, winner. Who do we have on the air?
Mario.
All right, Mario, where are you calling from?
I'm out here in Moreno Valley.
Moval, man, right on, man. That's a
my,
nice
my
town.
My workplace.
Yeah, that's where my Mama Liz works out there, man. All right, so congratulations, man. You're gonna enjoy a pair of tickets to the Random Comedy Jam that's taking place this Friday. Right there at the Deja Vu nightclub in the city of Ontario, man. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pass you back to our sound guy, and he's going to get some information from you. And what you do is you'll show up there this Friday and just give them your name, and they'll have tickets there for you, man. You know, they'll hook you up. All right, and I hope to see you out there. I'm looking forward to going out there myself this Friday.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right, and hold on, okay? All right. We have another caller on the air? All right. All right. Congratulations to Mario and Alicia on those random comedy jam tickets. going down this Friday right there at the Deja Vu in Ontario, the Deja Vu nightclub. All right, congratulations, man. So right now we're going to go back to DJ CX2 unless yes. Mama Liz has anything to say.
Just shout out to my bestie, Paula Flores. Yeah, just wanted to say hi.
No shout outs for you no more.
What?
Yeah, no more shout outs for you.
She's my bestie.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, she is. All right. All right. Let's go back to DJ CX2, man. Take it away, DJ CX2. Give us some dancing music. Caller, thank you for calling in to the Commish Hour. Who do I have on the air?
Yeah, Commish, this is your cousin.
Hey,
oh, another primo, huh? What's up, man? What are you guys trying to do? Have a family reunion right here?
Might well, huh?
I know that's the only time you can see him, huh?
What's going on, primo? We're going to get a few more minutes on the air.
You guys can DJ for our car show.
Oh, yeah.
On July 29th.
Oh, right on, July 29th. You guys want us to come out there to the OC and do some DJing, huh? Yeah, yeah. You know what?
Yeah.
Let me put you on hold and let me get the details from you because right now we're on the air, dude.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so let me get you on hold, okay? Hold on.
All right.
All right. Right on. Thanks, primo. All right, and we're trying to get some of these requests out to you guys. We're trying to get some of these requests out to you guys. So let's see. Now we got another one. We got Cruising Together, and we only got about 7 more minutes of airtime. So we're gonna try to fill your request. Okay?
CeCe can mix it up.
All right. And right now we're gonna go back to DJ CX2.
Jump on it, jump on it, jump on it, jump on it.
Orale gente, this is the Commish. I wasn't even watching the time because I'm paying attention over here. But we want to thank you once again for tuning in to the Commish Hour right here on KCAA Radio, 102.3 FM, 106.5 FM, 1050 AM, and that worldwide web at kcaaradio.com. Thank you. And remember, gente, continue to live the American dream. Cruise low and slow.
Good night.
Buenas noches.
KCAA Loma Linda. Listen on 1050 AM, 102.3 FM, and 106.5 FM.
Everybody out there from deep in the heart of the Wild West and pumping out loud and crystal clear from sea to shining sea and all the way from pole to freezing pole and everywhere there is in between. It is such an honor and a pleasure to welcome you to Midnight in the Desert. And I'm your host for the night, Heather Wade. And we have a returning controversial guest tonight, Dr. William Schnobelin. He's going to be joining us after the bottom of the hour break to talk about his latest book, Romancing Death, a true story of vampirism, death, the occult, and deliverance. So I know he is a polarizing guest. You know, some people absolutely love him, and some people absolutely just hate him. And I don't get it, but I found out last time he was on the program. Oh my gosh, I got so much email in response to Dr. Schnobelin. Actually, he likes me to call him Dr. Bill, which is fine. But I just couldn't believe how polarized everybody was about him. I mean, yeah, there's no in-between. Absolutely no in-between. So some people were telling me just never, ever, ever have him back on the show. And other people said, gosh, you know, everything he said was 100% true, and you got to have him back. He was the best guest I've heard in months, in months, and months, and months. So what does a person make of all that? Well, I will leave it up to you to decide. But I know it's going to be a very interesting conversation with Dr. William Schnobelin tonight, so I'm looking forward to that. And a bunch of news to go over here. Let me see now. Interesting news out of North Korea. A report in a Russian newspaper claimed that more than 600,000 people, about 25% of Pyongyang's population, are being urgently evacuated. And that's being blamed on tensions escalating between North Korea and the United States. And foreign reporters in North Korea have been told to prepare for a big and important event on North Korea's biggest national celebration coming up this Saturday in North Korea. It's called the Day of the Sun. And more than 200 foreign journalists are in Pyongyang as the country marks the 105th birthday of its founder, Kim Il-sung, on April 15th. And officials in North Korea have already warned that nuclear war could break out at any minute due to the extremely tense situation on the peninsula. Well, probably in response to the United States Navy sending a strike group towards the Western Pacific in a show of force. And North Korea is retorting with warnings of a nuclear attack in retaliation to any show of aggression. Ah, it's like a ticking time bomb. North Korean officials have given no clues as to the nature of this surprise big event that's coming up, or where that event would take place. However, in the past, announcements of a similar nature have turned out to be almost nothing. In 2016, foreign journalists underwent hours of investigation by North Korean officials ahead of what turned out to be a pop concert to mark the finale of the ruling.